Welcome to the lectures on surveying to CE 356. Today we will learn about trigonometrical leveling. So the main important thing about it is this: what is, first of all, before starting, what is the trigonometrical leveling? Trigonometrical leveling, it is nothing but it is a type of leveling in which we determine the elevation from the observed angle as well and with the help of the known distances. Here the vertical angles can be observed with the help of theodolite, while the distance can be measured with the help of tab. For simple case, we will try to understand what we are trying to do. What we are saying? We are saying that trigonometrical, it is a type of leveling in which the elevation or the differential elevation is determined on the behalf of or on the basis of the observed vertical angle and the measured or the known distances. So what we are trying to say, that let's say this is an object, or it is a chimney or anything, we are interested to find the difference in elevation or the height of this chimney. Let's represent it like something like this. This is an object. We are interested to find out the difference in elevation or the height of this. So what we are doing, this from this, with the help of the observed vertical angle as well as with measure distance. Let's call distance is this t, in between this and from the instrument station. This distance t can be measured with the help of tab, and with the help of theodolite we can measure this vertical angle. So this is what we are trying to explain, this definition of trigonometrical leveling, with a very simple example. This is a very simple example of trigonometrical leveling. We have made some complex examples also in which how to apply this trigonometrical leveling and how to find out the required parameters that we will discuss later. So this is what this is representing. The definition of trigonometrical leveling. So what is trigonometrical leveling? It is nothing but it is a type of leveling in which the difference in elevation can be determined with the help of the observed vertical angle and the measured distances. And this observed and this vertical angle can be measured with the help of theodolite. This vertical angle alpha we can measure with the help of theodolite or with the help of tachometer also. Well, the distance this, the horizontal distance this, the horizontal distance from the horizontal distance of this object from the instrument station can be determined with the or can be measured with the help of the tape. So this is what this trigonometrical leveling here. This trigonometrical leveling is broadly classified on the basis of the horizontal distances or the distance between the station point. This trigonometrical leveling can be broadly classified into two types. On the basis of distance between the station, the trigonometrical leveling is broadly classified into two types. That is, the first one is the observation of height and distance as geodetic survey. And the second one, the same observation of height and distance as plane survey. So the trigonometrical leveling is broadly classified into these two types. We can call this as a case A, or we can call this as a case B, or 1 or 2. This trigonometrical leveling is broadly classified into these two cases. Then case number 1 is the observation of height and distance as geodetic survey, where the distance will be measured as geodetic survey. And the second, the case number 2, what is about to say, the case number B is the observation of height and distance as plane survey. So here what the point should be understood, that what is the geodetic survey and what is the plane survey. So first of all, we will try to learn or we will try to see what is geodetic survey, and then we will see what is the plane survey, and then we will proceed further. And after that, we will try to learn the technometrical labeling for the case A, that is the observation of height and distance as geodetic survey. So first of all, let's see what is the geodetic survey and what is the plane survey. What is the plane survey? The plane survey, if we are suppose we are measuring a small area, then the small area like some building construction site, for the example, some construction of some building, some society, or the construction of some mall, or some construction of some small college building, some school building. That means to say, if we are measuring a small area like the building structures, then the area is assumed to be the flat, or assumed to be the flat surface. So then the survey which is occur on this kind of flat plane is called the plane survey. But this is not true, as we know that the world is not the flat. It is the world is not flat, or the earth is not flat. So when we are measuring or when we are doing the survey on a long area, for example like highways or railways. So in that situation, we cannot assume the area to be the flat. So at the time, it is mandatory to take into account the curvature of Earth. So when the curvature of Earth is taken into account, then the type of survey will be called the geodetic survey, because as it will be done for a longer distance or for a longer area. The curvature of Earth, will make a substance error in the elevation as well as in the height. So it is necessary to take into account. So what is the plane survey? If you are measuring a small area like building structure or something else, then the area is assumed to be flat, and the survey occurs on that kind of area is called the plane survey. But if you are doing the survey on a longer area, then it is necessary to take into account the curvature of Earth, and then the type of survey what you are doing, that is called as the geodetic survey. First of all, we will learn the case A, that is observation of height and the distance as geodetic survey. So in geodetic survey, we take into account the curvature of Earth. So when we will take into the curvature of Earth, there will be some error, that is the curvature error as well as the refraction error. So we will try to learn first what is curvature error and what is the refraction error. and address represents the curvature of earth. We know that the surveying instrument measures the distance along the line of sight. Therefore, the difference in elevation, or to say the height, can be measured by accounting the curvature of earth. Let's say this is the distance d. From A to A, the distance along this A to A range will be, the actual distance is D, but the distance what will be measured by the equipment will be this distance. Let's say that the staff is held vertical at point A, and then the actual distance between A to A will be the D, but the distance which will be measured by the equipment will be this D. So there will be some error due to this curvature of earth. So this error due to curvature will be this. So the error due to the curvature of earth is the this. So the c will represent the error due to the curvature. So this c is called as the curvature error. This is the curvature error. This curvature error can be calculated with the help of the Pythagorean theorem. So, how we can calculate this c here? If we apply the Pythagorean theorem, then it will be r plus c square equals to r square plus d square. So, it will be, we can solve it as r square plus d square plus 2rc equals to r square plus d square. This r square and this r square will get cancelled. So what will be left out? C square plus 2rc equals to d square. If we take the c common from here, then it will be c equals to d square divided by C plus 2R. This is the curvature error. Here we know that what is the denominator? Denominator here is C plus 2R. The R is, R represents the error of, R represents as, what is R? R is nothing but the radius of earth. This is equal to 6400 kilometer. Well, C is what? C is a curvature error. We know that the C will be very, very less than the R. As C is very, very less than R, it will be the negligible. The C is negligible as compared to R. So we can write the formula as C equals to d square divided by 2R. So this is what? The curvature error. If there is no refraction error, we have solved this expression for curvature error with an assumption that there is no refraction error. But this may not be true always. Also, what is the refraction error? Let us understand that. So this is representing the line of sight. But when we will keep the instrument at this point, the line of sight will be something like this. This line of sight, when we will do the survey on a large area, this line of sight will be reflected downward because of the earth atmosphere. So this, due to this earth atmosphere, this error which will be accumulated, that will be this error, and this error is known as the refraction error. This is known as refraction error. This refraction error depends on three parameters. Number one is atmospheric pressure. Second, the temperature. And then the last one is geographic location. So this reflection error depends upon the three parameters, that is atmospheric pressure, temperature and geographic location. So as the reflection error came into the picture, the correction curvature will be something else. So what it will be in that situation, the curvature correction, we denote the curvature correction as C. The curvature correction C will be D by 2R sine 1 second. Well, this is the center of Earth and here this will be the angle, let's call this angle theta. Theta is the angle subtended at the center of Earth. So in that situation, when there is reflection error, the curvature correction C will be the D by 2R sine 1 second. And this C will be equivalent to theta by 2. If C is theta by 2, in that situation the theta will be D by R sine 1 second. Theta is D by R, theta will be the D by R sine 1 second. And we represent the reflection correction as R. So reflection correction R will be M theta. The M is nothing but coefficient of reflection. The M is nothing but the coefficient of reflection. The coefficient of reflection, that is M, it is the ratio of the radius of curvature of Earth divided by the radius of curvature of line of sight. This radius of curvature is represented as R. Radius of curvature of Earth is R, while radius of curvature of line of sight is RS. So M will be nothing but R by RS, and it's a constant. Generally, this value used to be the 0.07, the coefficient of reflection. So here we have that. Reflection correction, R is nothing but R equals to M theta. So this we can write this as M. Here the value of theta is D by R sine 1 second. Let's write it as it is. M dot D by R sine 1 second. This what is the curvature correction C, D by 2R sine 1 second. Well, this is the reflection correction R. R is nothing but MT divided by R sine 1 second, where M is coefficient of reflection and M is nothing but the R by RS, where the R is radius of curvature of Earth and RS is radius of curvature of line of sight, and this value used to be the 0.07. So we have calculated the curvature correction as well as reflection correction individually. Now we want to find out the total correction. So total correction will be the C minus R. So what is the value of C? C we have D by 2R sine 1 second. Minus R, MD by R sine 1 second. this what? From here we can take d by r sine 1 second common. So but we will take d by 2 r sine 1 second common. So if I will take d by 2 r sine 1 second common, then there will be 1 minus, from here we have taken this common, we have multiplied by 2 and divided by 2. So d by 2 r sine 1 second is taken common, so what is left out here? 2 m. So 1 minus 2 m. So this is the total correction. Total correction d by 2 r sine 1 second into 1 minus 2 m. This total correction will be positive for the angle of elevation, and it will be negative for the angle of depression. That means it will be positive for the additive for the angle of elevation, and it will be negative for the angle of depression. It is positive for angle of elevation, and this is negative, or to say the subtractive, for the angle of depression. This is what the curvature error and refraction error, and we have seen some of the formulas for the corrections. Now let's have the next one, that is the axis signal correction. What is the axis signal correction? Let me draw the diagram figure first, then we will try to understand it. The axis signal correction and B are the two stations, and the signals are stored on both the station. And we are interested to measure the vertical angle from A to B. The signals are stored on both the and signals are stored on both the station. And the height of this instrument, the height of instrument at point A is h1, while the height of instrument at point B is s2, and the height of signal is s2. These signals are generally used to measure the vertical angles when we are doing the survey, when we are doing the geodetic survey. As the distance is very very longer, it is very difficult to bisect the particular points or to take the proper reading. So generally we use the signals for measuring the vertical angles. So generally we use these signals for measuring the vertical angles. As we know, the height of these signals will not be same at all the point. The height of signal will not be same at all the point. The height of signal at A may not be equal to the height of signal at B, or height of signal at B may not be equal to height of instrument at A. So there will be necessity to correct the vertical angle, to correct the observed vertical angle in order to get the true angle. As the height of signals are not same at both the station or at the different or height of signal is used to be different at the different stations, therefore there is this, so we are required to correct the observed vertical angle. The correction which is required for this correcting the vertical angle is called taxi signal correction. So in this situation, if the height of instrument at point A, let's say it's h1, and height of instrument and height of signal at point B, let's say it is s2. If the height of instrument at A, that is h1, is equal to s2, then the vertical angle observed alpha will be the corrected vertical angle. But the h1 is not equal to s2. Therefore, we require to apply the axis signal correction, or we are required to correct the observed vertical angle. So in this situation, the axis signal correction delta will be s2 minus h1 divided by t. The axis signal correction will be the s2 minus h1 divided by t. s2 minus the height of signal at B minus the height of instrument at A divided by the distance between them, that is d. This will be the axis signal correction. Here the point we should be noted that axis signal correction delta will be positive for the angle of depression. Right, it will be negative for the angle of elevation. Sign convention we need to follow, that axis signal correction will be positive for the angle of depression, while it will be negative for the angle of elevation. Let's solve an example on this axis signal correction so that the picture will be more clear. Signal at station Q is 5.3 meter. Two station P and Q are 5000 meter apart. Take the value of R sine 1 second as 30.88 meter. The coefficient of refraction may be assumed to be 0.07. So in this is what the question number A. In this, we are asked to calculate the true value if the angle of elevation is given. And the question number B, in the above question, also find the true value of angle of of angle observed if it was an angle of depression. Means both the cases are asked to find the true value if the observed angle was angle of elevation or the observed angle was the angle of depression. So let's solve the question number A, that is the angle of elevation. So let's try to draw the figure first and try to write the things in that what is given. This is the alpha, this is given as 3 degree 22 minutes 40 seconds. 45 seconds. This is point P. And this is the point Q. The height of instrument at P is given 1 meter. That means this H1, this is given as 1 meter. The height of signal at Q is 5.3. This is as 5.3 meter. The distance between two station P and Q is 5000 meter. That is this distance D equals to 5000 meter. This is 5000 meter. Next, the R side one is given as 30.88, and the coefficient of refraction, that is M, is assumed to be is given as 0.07. So this is what the figure. Let's write the given data. This is the given figure. This is the figure for the given data. The given data is right first 3 degree 22 minutes 45 seconds. H1 as 1 meter. The S2 as 5.3 meter. D as 5000 meter. And then fifth, R sine 1 second as 30.88 meter. Then the last, that is value of M, is given as 0.07. Okay, so first of all, we will solution. First of all, we will solve the excess signal correction, that is delta. The excess signal correction is nothing but S2 minus H1 divided by the D. So what is the S2? S2, what we have, 5.3. Divided by D. This is sine 1 second. So this is 5.3 minus H1, that is 1 meter, divided by D is given as 5000 and sine 1 second. So if we solve this, you will get seconds. If I will try to convert it into the minute, we know that 120 seconds will be equivalent to 2 minutes, so I can write it as 2 minute 50 second 57.38 second, because the overall is 177.38 second. After that, the 120 second will be going to 2 minutes, so I have written it as 2 minutes 57.38 second. Now let's find out the central angle, that is theta. Theta will be D by R sine 1 second. So D is given as 5000, while the value of R sine 1 second is already given in the problem, that is 30.88. So this will be 161.91 second. So if I will convert it into again minute, the 120 seconds will be the 2 minute, and then it will be 41.91 second, because first 120 second will be equivalent to 2 minute, and left out will be the 41.91 second, and the curvature correction C will be it is nothing but the theta by 2. So it will 161.91 divided by 2, this will be 80.95 seconds. This will be equivalent to 1 minute, first 60 seconds will be the 1 minute and then 20.95 seconds. This is curvature correction. Then refraction correction, R will be m theta. The value of m is given as 0.07 into the theta. Theta is 161.91 second. If we will solve this, we will get it as 11.33 seconds. Now we got all the things. We have calculated the axis signal corrections, we have already calculated the curvature correction, and we have also calculated the refraction correction. Now let's calculate the true angle. True angle, let's call this as alpha dash. It will be the alpha, and then for this particular case the axis signal correction will be negative. Why? Because the observed vertical angle is L is positive, that means it is the angle of elevation. That is because in question number 8 is given 3 degrees 22 minutes 45 seconds, even though it is directly even mentioned that the vertical angle of elevation. So angle of elevation is given. For the angle of elevation, the axis signal correction is used to be the negative. So this is negative, and from here C and R, the total correction will be C minus R. The total correction will be C minus R. So I can write the true angle, that is alpha dash will be alpha minus the axis signal correction plus C minus R, that is total correction. If I will write it for the angle of depression, then it will be minus alpha plus delta, that is axis signal correction will be positive for the angle of depression. So it will be delta plus or minus, then the next one will be the total correction. The total correction used to be the negative for the angle of elevation. So it will be then minus C plus R. So first in this problem number here, we have the angle of elevation only, so it will be alpha minus delta plus C minus R. So it will be, what is alpha? Alpha is the vertical angle, that is 3 degree 22 minutes and 45 seconds. Then delta is axis signal correction, it is 2 minutes 57.38 seconds minus 2 minutes 57.38 seconds plus C minus R. What is C? C is 1 minute 20.95 seconds plus 1 minute 20.95 seconds minus R, that is refraction. It will be 11.33 seconds. If you will solve this, we will get the true angle, that is alpha dash, as 3 degrees 21 minutes and 7.62 seconds. So what was the angle measured? Angle was measured 3 degrees 22 minutes 45 seconds, but the actual angle is 3 degrees 21 minutes 7.62 seconds. This is the case A. Now let's solve the case number 2, that is the angle of depression. So angle of depression, for this the alpha will be minus 3 degrees 22 minutes 45 seconds. Okay, and then axis signal correction. The axis signal correction will be positive. As we know that if the angle of elevation is axis signal correction used to be negative for angle of elevation, and the axis signal correction used to be positive for angle of depression. Now we are solving the case number B, that is the angle of depression. So for the angle of depression, this axis signal direction will be positive, and this total direction, that is 3 minus r, it will be the subtractive or it will be the negative for the angle of depression. That means it will be minus 3 plus r for the angle of depression. So what changes I have to make here? Minus alpha plus delta minus c plus r. That means minus 3 degree plus 2 degree 57 minute 57.38 second minus this curvature direction, that is 21 minute 20.94 second plus refraction direction, that is 11.33 second. If we will solve this, we will get this as minus 3 degree 21 minute 7.62 second. So this is how we solve the problems for axis signal correction. So in today's lecture, we will start it with trigonometrical leveling. We learn what is trigonometrical leveling, and trigonometrical leveling is broadly classified into two cases, that is the observation of height and distance as plane survey, and the second case number 2, that is observation of height and distance as geodetic survey. Out of that, we started today with the observation of height and distances as geodetic survey. In that we have started, and that we learned first what is plane survey and then geodetic survey, the correction for curvature and correction for refraction. Then we learned about the axis signal corrections. Thank you.